And I believe that's butter something. I can't quite remember her name. Sorry. She's another Oneida County politician. You gotta have the politicians present. They gotta show they care. I don't know why I'm concentrating on the politicians. It's 9/11. It's not about the politicians. Right there is the chief of the Rome Police Department. The chief.
Today we have members of the Rome Fire Department, Rome Police Department, here today. It's a true representation of the first responders of the Pentagon City. We are today to remember those lost when they made it to the Pentagon in 2001. Those included 343 members of the 1857 officers of the New York Police Department, 23 officers of the New York Police Department, 12 law enforcement officers from other state and federal agencies, 8 emergency medical technicians and paramedics, 55 members of the armed forces at the Pentagon, 2,155 civilians in New York, at the Pentagon on the field in Somerset County, Pennsylvania. Let us also remember the thousands of first responders who have become ill after responding to rescue and recovery efforts at ground zero. At this time, I would like to ask Father Sean O'Brien to say the invitation.
Pray. Almighty God, we thank you for bringing us together this evening. We thank you for the great weather. It gives us an opportunity to come together as a community. As we remember, Lord, the events of 2001, we ask that you always help us to never forget the importance of faith, of family, of friends, and of community. Help us, Lord, always to be the good people created us to be, and to remain strong in our communities, with our friends, with our families, and whatever faith we may carry. And we ask this in your holy name. Amen.
I would now like to ask any of you all to sing the national anthem.
Thank you.
these public tools are confronted with more dangerous work environment than ever before. We are forced to continually change our strategies and tactics to accomplish our tasks. Our methods may change, but our goals remain the same as they were in the past. To save lives and protect property for sometimes at a terrible cost. This is what we do. This is our chosen profession. This is the condition of firefighting. The fire service of today is ever changing. The steepened traditions, 200 years old. One such tradition is the sound of a bell. In the past, as firefighters began their tour of duty, it was the bell that signaled the beginning of that day's shift. Throughout the day and night, each alarm was sounded by a bell. Some of these brave souls to fight fires and place their lives in jeopardy for the good of their fellow citizens. When the fire was out and the alarm had come to an end, it was the bell that signaled the completion of the call. The firefighter had died in the line of duty, paying the supreme sacrifice. It was the mournful toll of the bell that solemnly announced the comrade's passing. We utilize these traditions as symbols. Like honor and respect to those who have given so much and who have served so well. Symbolizing the devotion that these great souls had to their duty, a special signal of five rings, three times each, represents the end of our comrades' duties and they will be returning accordingly. And so, to those who have selflessly given their lives for the good of their fellow man, their task completed, their duties well done, to our comrades, their last alarm, they are gone. In addition, our hope is to repaint all the existing plaques to show the past members the respect they deserve. The city has assisted us with this, with the majority of the funding. If anyone would like to donate to this effort, we have information available at Central Fire Station. We have two plaques to dedicate this evening. They are to honor deceased past Fire Chief William L. Castor and his son, and retired firefighter William C. Castor and his family, please stand. Plaques read, Chief William L. Castor, 1954 to 1987. Dedicated, fearless, and uncommon courage. Loving husband, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, and friend. Firefighter William C. Castor, 1979 to 1992. Firefighters are indispensable foot soldiers here at home. Loving husband, father, and papa. I would like to invite Mayor Izzo to come to the podium and say a few words.
Where's Mayor? I'm Izzo.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you all for being here this evening. This is a day that we must continue to commemorate. We're 22 years out, and when you begin to see the pictures and watch the footage, you feel like you're right back. Everyone knows where they were that day, probably name, the hour, the minute. Just knowing exactly what you were doing, you know, that's that time. And yet, we have people that commit their lives to the military service, the fire, police, the EMS, our ambulance services, and they still fight this good fight because they want to help people. 9/11 forever changed our country, the world, and today that still resonates. For those families where their loved ones never came back home, we must never forget for them. We because when they wake up on this day every year, they relive that horror, as do the rest of us. I want to say thank you to our first responders, our police and fire, our military, both at home and abroad. They continue to protect us, keep us safe. I want to also thank our local fire and police for keeping this ceremony alive in our community, because it is so important. And to the members, my colleagues, and the elected government, thank you for being here with us tonight in our ceremony of honor. God bless all of you.
Thank you, Mayor. At this time, I'd like to invite Father Sean back to the podium for a benediction. Almighty God, as we go our separate ways this evening, we thank you for helping us to remember. We ask, Lord, that you watch over, bless, and protect our New York State Police, our Oneida County Sheriff and his deputies, our Rome City Police, Rome City Fire Department, all of the volunteer fire departments in the surrounding areas, as well as the men and women of the Army and the Navy, Air Force, Coast Guard, Marine Corps, and the Merchant Marine. We ask this in our holy name. Amen. This concludes today's ceremony. Thank you all for attending.
That's one big flag to the fold. Supervise. Make sure they do it right.